that's another win for Raven West.
I just don't get how they're doing it. Is it something in the fuel system?
It's not the cars. It's McCain. He's a force of nature out there.
Doesn't hurt that he was raised on milk from a cash cow.
What Raven West wants, Raven West buys.
How did you arrive at Raven West?
I just won a street racing festival in Brasilia when Mark Cruzado offered me the seat at Seneca. I didn't even hesitate. But before I could sign, Ryan McCain offered me twice as much to join Raven West. Best team, best car, a chance at a legacy. How could I say no?
Please, can I get a selfie?
Of course you can. Anything. Thank you so much. No, my pleasure.
Perfect. Thank you.
Thanks. You see?
Do you ever regret your choice?
Not if we keep winning.
Look, we aren't getting near Raven West. It just doesn't feel possible. Let's just give it one more go and see how close you can get. From our telemetry, he's making up time on the straights like he's carrying more horsepower than he's allowed.
Nate's pace is untouchable. Not denying his talent, but getting close shouldn't be this hard.
Thing is, he gets out in front, then it's game over. You can't catch him.
I'm fast. 22 is fast. We should be able to catch Nate, but I can't see where we can push harder.
Keep pushing. Try and find at least a second.
It's almost as if he's got another gear, one we don't have. I can't explain it.
Part of me wants to dispute this with the officials, but that isn't what we do. And they are the champions. I expect them to be fast. We can find a way, though.
Lara has a slower time, more in line with what I'd expect. Still fast, but achievable. His cornering looks like he's on a rail. Not losing traction and turning in at speed I'd expect would cause oversteer.
It's Seneca number 22 coming in third place tonight.
Both Seneca cars reach the podium. Another great day for the team.
McCain wins it, but wow, did Seneca give him a run for his money.
What do you think about Seneca's current form?
In a word? Unprecedented.
Incredible.
Decent.
You ask me again, you see what happens.
It's not just that they've worked their way into the upper midfield on such a small budget. It's that they're finally doing it with both drivers.
Right now, this moment, this is the best we've ever been. But when you succeed, people want more. So it's time for us to deliver.
We're going live to Raven West driver Nathan McCain. How are you feeling about this race, and are you worried about the new double threat of Seneca and Volz?
Actually, lead Raven West driver, thank you. Look, I'm not worried about any of these other teams. New, old, whatever. I'm just out here racing for my fans. Because without them, we couldn't do what we do.
Well, good luck, Nathan. And judging by the amount of Raven West shirts in the crowd, you have a lot of support out there.
Good luck, Tony T.
Raven West team rattled, regardless of what they say in England. Race hard, scare the McCain. was a tough race.
North Point will be shattered after that first lap retirement, but one man's trash is another's treasure, and I'm sure Seneca are extremely happy with that result today. There is a fair amount left for them to prove, but so far, so good. And it's another chance for them to show their prowess in the electric racing events, where drivers get a nice and spicy speed boost for hitting the boost zones.
Okay, keep the pressure on Raven West. We can get close to them.
Going into lap two. Lost places to a crash. We'll be right back.
this rate, we'll have a real shot at the gauntlet.
Seneca are smashing this season and may soon be graduating from their false rivalry to potentially chasing Ravenwest. I'm eager to see this play out.
Last season, Volts were shut out of the Pro League entirely. Now they've made it to the pros, they are becoming a real threat.
Hey, watch where you're going.
What is his problem? Maybe we'll be the ones to take down Ravenwest.
Do you think a team like Seneca stands a chance with Nathan McCain out there?
Maybe if they had two Yuma Tanakas. Teams today need to be firing on both cylinders if they want to stand a chance. But if this newbie does good, then bring it on, baby. That's why we're here.
Seneca's goal this year was to beat Volts. But now they're doing as well as they are, they've got to be asking themselves whether they should shoot higher. And in the grid, nobody is higher than Ravenwest.
It's great to see rivalries out on the track. Friendly like Volts and Seneca, or not so friendly like Ravenwest and, well, every other team on the grid. And it seems like Ravenwest are feeling the heat. Volts and Seneca were only promoted to the pros at the start of the year, but already look to finish higher than predicted, and could go all the way to the gauntlet.
Feels good not to be carrying this team on my own, 22. Good luck.
You need to finish in the top four. Good luck. Don't be surprised if they're gunning for you now. right, the time on the last lap was a 2:01.7.
So, you think you're fast? Well, time attack is where you can prove yourself against the competition. In this discipline, you'll be sharing the track with other competitors, all trying to get the fastest lap time. So, not only do you have to achieve eye-watering lap times, you have to do it while avoiding the race traffic. With a set number of laps to lock that fastest lap in place, every second counts if you want to drive away a time attack champion.
We are now live just before the race with Raven West boss Ryan McCain. Ryan, are you surprised with the sudden rise of Seneca? Do you think that they are a threat to your season?
Seneca have been lucky, but they have no reserve drivers left. They're on thin ice. There's nothing for them to fall back on if a driver eats a dodgy oyster, you know? And this is their last chance, and it's a position a professional manager wouldn't put their team in.
Well, you heard it.
I hate to say it, but Ryan's right. Having no reserve drivers isn't a great position to be in. Just keep doing what you're doing and we'll be alright.
Hey, no negativity before we race. 22, don't worry about it. Let's just keep doing what we are doing.
careful. I saw what happened on the monitors. Nate is not playing nicely.
Yeah, I won't lie, this season's been disappointing for me, personally.
Nathan McCain trying to overtake Valentin Mandina, and he's been clipped! McCain putting Manzi out of action once again.
Nate! What was that today, man?
You got a problem with me, Valentine? I got no problem dealing with you.
If you want to trash talk me in the press, that's fine. You keep peeling up there, that stops. But you're gonna get somebody hurt. Yeah?
Hopefully, it'll be you.
Hey! Hey! Hey!
So he knows Kung Fu. I'm still faster than him.
What about Seneca? People are saying they're the real threats, and you seem to get more aggressive every time you face them.
You know what? I'm done. Take your mic. Okay.
The cars are lined up on the grid, ready for the start of the race, but just before lights out, we are linking live to Valentin Manzi. Valentin, how has the jump to the Pro Leagues been so far?
It's been interesting. And you know, I really admire Seneca. As someone who's a connoisseur of martial arts, I like the fighting spirit. Shke? Martial arts? Fighting? Sorry. I was Manzi's plane in. Oh, that was rough. Sorry.
Yeah, that was a shocker, Manzi. But good luck. We will all certainly be watching both Volt and Seneca, two teams with real podium potential.
Listen, stay out McCain's path. He's losing control and acting reckless. Seems he's not taking being challenged very well.
McCain doesn't concern me. We are here to win. Let's go!
With our race in Sydney wrapped up, we head towards Okutama, and teams must be looking at the gauntlet like a storm on the horizon. It's about to get intense. Well, more intense.
Expectations. Yumi Tanaka in particular has become a standout driver, pushing Seneca up the table. Aaron, what are your thoughts?
Yeah, Yumi's skill has shone through as Seneca's number one driver. She's definitely been thriving with the support of number 22, and together, they've really become a winning combination.
We all love to see her race, and we get to see that right now here at the Grid World Series.
We're doing great right now. Keep it up.
Agreed. Senegal's never been better. But now, we race. Glad I have you on my side, 22. We make a good team.
No matter what the conditions, you both push Seneca to be the best we can be.
Raven West, Nathan McCain and Laura Carvalho leading the charge here at Strada Alpina.
With Seneca's Yumi Tanaka hot on their heels,
could this be the race where she makes Grid World Series history? Tanaka spot McCain doesn't like it.
Contact!
In a situation like this, all you can do is hope that the drivers are all okay.
We're still investigating the cause of the accident, but right now it appears there was a fault in the active suspension system combined with a direct impact to the right rear tire. Yume Tanaka is out of surgery and in stable condition, but she,
they had to amputate the leg below the knee.
Hey.
How does this affect Seneca's chances of qualifying for the gauntlet?
Should go home, Ajit. It's been a long day. Resigning?
Yumi's one of my closest friends. And that wheel, it should never have come off. No matter how reckless McCain might have been.
They want to sell the team, G.
Who does?
Board of directors. They gave me an ultimatum. Deliver a miracle, or I'm gone. And they tried to recoup their investment.
Can they even do that?
They could do whatever they want. We can still qualify, though. We just need to up our game. No more mistakes. No self-pity either.
You're asking a lot from one driver.
I'm asking a lot from both of you.
We would like to wish Yume Tanaka a speedy recovery. She's in all of our thoughts. And we must also thank Seneca Racing for taking part, despite recent events.
last lap to show off your drifting skills.
Seneca down to one driver after Yumi's accident has put her out of the competition. With no more reserve drivers left, surely this is all downhill for Seneca.
It's a very sad situation for Seneca. Nobody wants to be in this position, and you certainly can't blame Marcus Adot for striving to find the best in it. Unfortunately, only being able to get half the points will cost them in the long run.
Thanks, Aaron. And it is incredible to see the fighting spirit of driver 22 carrying the whole team alone.
We didn't come this far just to give up now. Let's carry this on for Yumi. I know you have it in you. Just do what you always do. That's good enough for me.
This is going to be rough. We can get half points, maximum. You'll see us drop down the leaderboard, but every win opens a parachute and slows us down. Okay, the time last lap was a 1:44.6. We'll be right back. last lap was A1:38.9. Last lap was A1:36.2. A1:35.7.
Next race,
teams are going to start dropping out. Do your best.